Some of us scientists need to work on human disorders, need to see a real relevance to what we're doing. And apparently that's me. Sometime last year, I decided that I would be totally happy with my career if I could say that I contributed to one therapy for Angelman syndrome.
Katie, she was actually diagnosed when she was about 2.5. She has imprinting, which is one of the rarer types. The most common is deletion.
They say that these kids have intellectual disability, but they get it. They're people, they're wonderful little people. You know, they're a lot like my own kids and having senses of humor and things like that. You'll meet Katie. You'll see the same sense of humor and delightful personality. She doesn't say a word, but you'll see the same personality.
Joey, he was diagnosed at 19 months. He is deletion positive, which is one of the most common genotypes in Angelman syndrome. We're truly happy with who Joey is. It's, you know, it's a blessing, and it comes with a lot of struggles having Angelman syndrome and having it be a part of our family, but I think we're doing our best to just, you know, move along every day.
No.
No, you don't think so?
Like a lot of Angelman kids, Joey's very happy, very excitable, and very wound up. He speaks to me because he's roughly the same age as my daughter.
Stormy's so attached to Angelman syndrome, I feel like. It's not just about the science, it's not just about how much money can I raise. She is so interested in our kids. I'm really excited that she's just a part of this community because she's really a special person.
I invite the families to the lab because, first of all, we ask them to be involved in our studies. But second of all, I want my students to meet the families so that they know why they do the work that they do.
Katie loves to go to the lab. She thinks that they're all there to serve her. And Stormy makes us feel very welcome. Stormy's so energetic and positive about all the research that's happening that it makes us feel like there's hopeful things happening.
Stormy's probably one of the very few that can put herself in our shoes to see really what it's like living with Angelman syndrome on a daily basis. And I think if she can possibly do anything to eliminate the heartache that some of us families experience, she's going to do her best, that she, you know, the best she can to do that.
Angelman syndrome is a single gene disorder. We know that the kids have the disorder because they're missing this one gene, UBE3A. We know ways to restore that gene expression. I'm confident that there will be some sort of clinical trial aimed at correcting Angelman syndrome. And there are actually pieces of the disorder I hope we can never fix. The kids are really happy, right? Why would you want to correct that? It's a real part of the syndrome, and I hope we can fix everything but that.